There was a red-headed, freckle-faced kid named Bill Walton, and I went down to watch him play, and I came back, and I was telling Coach Wooden about him, and I said, Coach, I think he's the best high school basketball player I've ever seen.
And I said to Denny, never say that. People think you're crazy. And to say he's the best you've ever seen.
When I hit that door running as a high school graduate, 17 years old, I'm sprinting out the door, free at last. Here I am on my own. And Coach Wooden's standing up there on the steps there at UCLA saying, Walton, come right on in here. You're mine for the next 4 years.
There was a great chasm between the free-spirited Bill Walton as a person and the very conservative coach John Wooden, who held the reins of the UCLA team. And one of the great achievements, I think, was they were able to mesh as a team.
Coach Wooden knew how to take the star players on the team and then put complementary players around them based on what the skills of that star were.
Combining for half their team's first half points, Curtis, number 22, and Wilkes, number 52, were the central figures in an 8-minute scoring explosion.
Just the thought of playing a basketball game with Bill Walton was just exciting. He understood that playing defense and rebounding were just as critical to the team's success as scoring.
Walton, however, is overpowering. In the first half of play, he scores 24 of UCLA's 39 points.
The Bruins tore through opponents in the regular season, pushing their winning streak to 71 games.
And we would just race through it all. And then when it was over, Coach Wooden would just give us that nod and say, that was all right, and let's see what we got tomorrow.
Rolling to the Final Four with ease, UCLA dispatched Indiana, setting up a Walton showcase against Memphis State in the finals.
And tipping in some perfect lob passes from guard Greg Lee. Walton hit three in a row to lead UCLA back to a four-point lead.
So we started doing that play, and I believe it might have been six times consecutively. I just came down, threw the ball up, and he scored.
During one of the timeouts, Greg Lee looked at the coach and looked around all of us and said, hey, Coach, Bill is shooting every single time down him. He's got a ton of points. We're up by 25 already. Can we run another play? And Coach Wooden looked at Greg, looked at all of us, and said, why?
It was 21 for 22. I kid Bill when I see him now and then and say, Bill, my defense made you real famous.
This was a team that really in many ways matched and outdid the record of the Alcindor team before them.
And I think that was that team's way of telling everybody, we had a great player and we were a great team, and they showed you both in that championship game.
Even though I had 21 baskets that night, our guards had 23 assists between them. This was not Bill Walton basketball. This was UCLA basketball.
UCLA's string of seven consecutive championships is a mark that still stands today. And the Walton Gang was a major contributor to the run. Walton Gang, that's a pretty clever nickname.